What's going on, guys? McSkillet here, and today I'm going to be doing a video on 5 of the most expensive and rare skins that have been owned by pro players for CSGO. This is not in any particular order, I just went through a lot of pro players and tried to pick out the skins which are pretty much the best that pro players have owned in the past, and some of them currently still do own these skins. Some pro players have actually owned some of the most valuable items for CSGO, so I'm going to be going over 5 of them in this video. Of course, I'm sure I'm missing some because I don't watch too many pro games, and I just tried to pick 5 pretty rare and pretty unique skins and knives that have been owned by pro players. So without further delay, let's get right into this video. So starting off, we have an AK-47 that's owned by Splice Aria, and this is a pretty sweet looking case harden. It's actually the same pattern that was on that StatTrak Factory New AK case harden that was unboxed. Of course, this is not StatTrak and Factory New. I believe it's field tested, but still, this is a really nice pattern, and I haven't seen too many pro players that have AKs with this nice of a pattern, but yeah, this looks completely blue. There's just a spot in the back where there's a bit of gold, but from the right angle, it looks completely blue actually, which is kind of cool about that pattern. Next up, we have Pasha's knife, and I believe this is donated by Motar2K, and this is a Karambit fade, but it's also a really, really good Karambit fade. Like, I believe it's a fake 90-10 pattern, so almost the complete fade. It's kind of hard to tell the difference between this fade pattern and the completely faded pattern, so it's basically the second best type of pattern, and it also has a really low float and a pretty nice corner. So this is just a really nice Karambit fade owned by Pasha with low float, good pattern, and pretty good corner, so a very nice Karambit fade, probably worth a lot more than a normal one. Now next up, we definitely have one of the most valuable skins that was owned by a pro player, except I believe when he used it, it actually wasn't worth hardly anything because it was before the stickers were super expensive. But we have Swag's old AK-47 Redline with the 4 iBuy Power Holos on it. I'm not sure exactly which condition it was. I believe it was either a field tested or minimal wear. Probably minimal wear, but yeah, this is a really valuable skin. I believe they're selling for over $2,000 now. If someone has 4 of these iBuy Power Holos on their AK Redline, but Swag, I believe he is still banned from pro games for the match fixing scandal or whatever, but either way, he used to have this skin, and now it's worth an absolute fortune, so might as well include it in the video. So next up, we have Hiko's old knife, and this is the StatTrak version. I showcased the non-StatTrak version, I believe, a couple days ago on my channel, because I was talking about how it sold for $10,000, but this is the actual StatTrak version right here, and I believe there's been people that have offered $20,000 or more to try to get this knife, but it's owned by some Dubai collector, and I don't believe he's ever going to sell it, but this is such a valuable knife, and basically one of the best blue gems out there, double-sided and StatTrak. I believe it is the best StatTrak gem. And finally, we have Guardian's old op. Guardian used to own a minimal wear op Dragonlore souvenir with a Guardian signature on it. It's got basically perfect sticker placement, has the Guardian sticker on the scope, and it also has really, really good float for a minimal wear. I believe it's selling like 0.08, so it's almost factory new, and it actually has one of the best oppers, or some argue to be the best opper, Guardian, on the scope. So a pretty insane item, but he no longer owns this op for some reason. I guess someone offered him a lot, and I guess he just decided to sell it. But either way, this is definitely one of the most valuable skins owned by a pro player. But again, this video wasn't in any particular order. I believe the Hiko's knife is probably worth a little more than this Dragonlore, even just because how nice that blue gem is. But that's pretty much it for this video, guys. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'm McSkillet, and I'm out.